Welcome to Formidable Fashion Review, Drag Race Series 3 edition, with your hosts, Victor Baskerville and...
Jasmine Villiers. Hello.
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 Before we get on to judging the looks today, I think we need to talk about that challenge.
Yeah, wow.
Potentially one of the worst challenges ever on the entire franchise of Drag Race.
It's just a lot to unpack.
A lot to unpack.
I mean, the queens were great. The queens were good. I just think what they were told to do was horrendous.
Yeah. Oti Mabusa, stick to Strictly next time.
Yeah. It reminded me of like a cruise. Like, you know when you go on a cruise and like it's like a really cheap cruise and like the entertainment is like terrible,
yes,
and like really cringy, and you kind of just want to leave, but you have to stay because you bought the ticket, or you're there with your grandparents. That happened to me.
You're cruising with your grandparents.
Oh. Not my grandparents, but I do with my sugar daddy. Shh, secret. Let's go on to the looks.
So this week, the queens were asked to do a look that was a red carpet showstopper, and up first we have Theresa May. So there's certainly a theme with Theresa, and it seems to be that everything she does is inspired by Spain. And I'm a little bit bored now. Like, she's had, the first entrance was a Matador look. She came as the Picasso, the Spanish art, and now she's a sort of quasi-flamenco dancer. It's like, we get it. You are from Spain.
But she's Spanish.
Yes, but you don't need to make everything about your nationality. I just find it boring. Sorry, Theresa. Literally everything was about being Spanish, apart from her hometown look, which was about being from Newcastle, which is not her hometown.
Yeah. But was the art really that Spanish?
Yes.
I like this. I think it's really cool. I think, I love the silhouette. I love the sparkly belt. The sort of, the way it's laid out on her body. I think it's cool. I mean, would I wear it on the red carpet? Probably not. I think it could do without having the blue thing underneath. I think if she literally just had the dress, the overdress, it would look a lot more glamorous.
Yeah, it's not very glamorous, and that's what you want from a red carpet look. This is a bit more pantomime dating.
Yeah, I love what she's done with the wig though, having the wig as the headpiece, that's incredible.
Yeah, that is very cool.
Unique.
But overall, I still don't like it, especially not for an eleganza red carpet look. So, I give this a boot.
I give this a toot. Theresa, we love you. Stunning. So, up next, we have Electra Fence. So what do we think of this?
Well, later on in the episode, when Alucard's giving the critiques, I think he hits the nail on the head by saying that she looks like a gay Jedi. And yeah, that's all I could see subsequently. Just this sort of weird robe, which would never be seen on a red carpet, with a hood. Who's got a hood on a red carpet?
Yeah.
I do quite like the wig. Kind of chic. But the outfit just swallows her.
Yeah.
I like the way it shimmers and the runway lights. That's very nice.
But it's shimmer.
But it's all a bit too monotone.
Yes, I agree. I think that... I get what she was going for. I think she was going for a futuristic vibe, you know, future 2020 sporty vibe. But I mean, to me, it just looks like a hoodie that's glittery with a skirt attached that's really glittery.
Yes.
So I mean, I get what she's going for, but it doesn't scream red carpet to me. It doesn't scream like I wouldn't notice. She wouldn't stand out to me on the red carpet.
But that's partly because she's 5'2".
Yeah, sure. I do not have that problem.
7-foot-tall lady.
Okay, should we move on? Oh wait, no,
we haven't
talked about it.
Yes, well, I think it's clear anyway. I definitely boot this.
Yeah. It's on the cusp for me because I do love sparkly shit.
Yeah.
But, which I give her props to that, but it's a boot. It's a boot. Boot.
And not even a nice boot. Like an stumpy working man's boot.
Yeah. Oh wow, that's really harsh. Zwei mehr.
That's why you love me.
How much will you pay?
200 rubles.
It's not enough. 2,000.
2,000 rubles.
How much would you actually be a whore for?
Either.
I probably wouldn't pay more than a pound.
Pound of flesh, pound of...
Yeah. Grab this pussy. Right, so next up we have...
Me?
No, Vanity Milan.
Oh, okay. And she's wearing a floral lilac number.
Yes.
With a cape, apparently inspired by Beyoncé in the Met Gala carpet.
Oh, was it?
Yes.
I love this. I really like this. For me, this is the most red carpet thing I've seen so far. Mm. I love the colours on her. I love the silhouette with the flowers going in and then out, then in. Mm. I don't love the cape as it first comes out, but then once she's flowing with the cape flowing behind her, it just looks beautiful. A little bit demure. I think she's... I don't like to cover my shoulders, but I guess that's her choice. It'd be nicer if it was off the shoulder. Maybe
you don't like to cover anything, so... I think this is pretty. I think there are a few styling issues. I don't think the really chunky necklace works very well. And I think the hair needs to be bigger to compensate for all the volume that she's got going underneath. There is something about the floral pattern on her body. It almost looks like Austin Powers' chest hair. You know how he's really hairy?
No, I don't see that at all.
Pink chest hair.
I don't see that at all.
Yeah, she just hasn't trimmed for the past 3 years. And the makeup as well.
Rich.
The makeup as well, maybe she puts on too much highlighter, but her face looks sweaty.
Oh yeah, maybe a little less highlight on the forehead. Tula boot.
Oh, I'm gonna have to boot this one. I like it, but it doesn't, it just so this style wrong.
It's a toot for me. It's a fucking toot. Shall we move on?
Let's move on. Okay, so up next we have Kitty Scott Claw.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
In her Marilyn Monroe, Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend inspired outfit.
Diamonds. Diamonds. A girl's best friend.
Wow. It sounds like demons are a girl's best friend. You've been possessed by one.
Oh my god, bitch. You're a fucking vampire motherfucker.
Anyway, what do you think of this look?
Rich bitch. I love it. I like it. This is gorgeous. I just think it's Mallamumrow. She looks fucking beautiful. You can't tell me she doesn't look beautiful. Last week you compared her to that meme dude. Mm-hmm. You can't tell me she looks like him tonight.
No, this is the most beautiful we've seen her, I think, for sure. I think she looks good here. I think it doesn't quite fit her around the breast area. It's a bit baggy.
Really?
Yeah.
A little bit, I guess.
Especially when she turns around and you can see all the loose fabric. It doesn't, yeah, it just looks a bit ill-fitting. And she's got a big frame. She needs bigger hair to compensate for that. She's got this tiny little wig that's sculpted around her head and it needs to be bigger. It just resembles too much the original Marilyn Monroe look. It's sparkly, which is a little bit more drag, but
pretty.
She's not a Marilyn Monroe imitator.
Pretty.
She's a drag queen. It needs to be. But overall, I do give it a toot.
I give it a toot. Big toot. So up next we have Crystal Versace. Looking fucking dashing. Wow. Mm-hmm. It's cute. What do we think?
She does look amazing. I mean, she's really living up to her name this time because this could be a Versace look.
Like, yeah.
Down a Versace runway. It is incredible. Like, from everything to the way the hair is styled, to the makeup, to the way she wears the dress. She wears it down the runway really appropriately. Because it's still sultry and sexy, but it's also a gown, so she's being glamorous, she's not trying to camp it up or anything. And that is something that runway models always have to learn, is to walk appropriately for the thing they're wearing.
Yeah,
so she's like a model.
She's a fucking model. She's a model with huge tits.
I do think they are maybe a little bit too big because the fabric of the dress is pushing them up and you can see like the bending at the top.
I don't know if I see that.
Like they're too...
Really? No, I don't really agree. Yeah, I mean, I really like the tits. I have been known to wear tits in my time.
Overwhelmed by tits last week. They've gone missing this week. Someone stole them.
I love this. This is incredible. This is green. This is sexy. I wouldn't say it could be going down a Versace runway just because I don't think they would choose this fabric to go down the runway. This isn't like a very Versace fabric, but it's beautiful, it's sparkly, it's drag, it's fitted. It's stunning. I love it.
I would say maybe it does need something to break up all of the colour. It's very monotone, but that's the only thing.
Yeah.
So overall, I'd definitely give this a toot.
I would give it a toot. Yeah, gorgeous.
So up next, we have River Medway.
River!
Looking much more glamorous than we've usually seen her look.
Yeah. Oh, I fucking love this. This for me is my favorite look of the runway so far.
Oh, really?
I would say so.
More than Crystal Versace?
Yeah. Let me, the thing about crystals was it was beautiful, don't get me wrong. But as you said, it was one color. I think it's something that wouldn't steal the show at an actual red carpet. Whereas this would steal the show at an actual red carpet, I think. You know, the way there's a bow on the side, on the top. You know, that there's the two patterns. There's the blue and the iridescent purple. The flow of everything. The way there's something here and something here. This is what I would love to wear on a red carpet.
Mm-hmm. This is absolutely the best that River has looked. And I agree with you, the proportions are completely right for her body. The flow of the fabric is really pretty. And the way that it's, the silhouette as well, where the way it's balanced out with the shoulder and then the hip details. I do think the hair is a little bit messy.
Really? No, I love the hair. It's fucking, it's 90s. It's 90s hair.
No, it just needs a bit more sleekness, I think, to it. It's too messy if you see it.
No, I love the hair. Come on.
No.
The hair's gorgeous.
It looks like she's got a little, tiny little bangs. Or fringe as a wig, and then plonked another wig on top. It doesn't look good to me.
I don't agree.
I would also say that I don't think she quite has the confidence to sell the beautiful glamorous dress down the runway yet.
No.
She's a little bit meek walking down, and she's relying on her comedy again. And which is fine because she knows it's going to appeal to the judges, but it doesn't suit the look. Like, if you're looking this beautiful, you need to act like you are that beautiful. Overall, I definitely give it a toot though.
Oh my god. I think a shoot. Can you give a shoot? Or no, is it toot? Okay, a toot. 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 Inspired by Cartier tonight, can you tell?
Yeah, you look just like it.
Better than her. Oh my god, the Cartier fans are gonna come for me.
They are gonna come for you.
If they watch, which they probably
won't. They're everywhere. Well, Russian spies are everywhere.
Oh my god.
So
Russia will take it down.
Yes.
Up next, we have Veronica Green.
That is correct.
Veronica Green! What do you think?
I like this. There's nothing much to say about it really. I don't know. It doesn't. I don't hate it, and I don't really like it. It just is a bit meh. Like it's fine. There's nothing to criticize. I would say. Maybe apart from that nose contour, she does look a bit like a swordfish. But the hair's different to anything we've seen Veronica in before, which is good.
I kind of disagree. I really liked this actually. I loved it when I came out on the runway. And I think it's cool, it is kind of like sunshine. And what sold it for me was the runway presentation. You know, the way she was like, you know, sort of like sauntering down the runway, kind of like a disco diva. I like the tour.
What's she doing?
She's sort of like...
Yeah,
Yeah, I like it, you know. My one critique actually was the hair. I don't really love the hair. Okay. I get what she's going for, but when I saw it with her face, it just didn't look quite right to me. I don't know why, but this for me is a 2.
Yeah, I give it a 2 as well, but it's not. It's a soft 2 for me.
Okay.
So up next we have Charity Case in a orange koi fish inspired 1920s flapper outfit.
Yeah, I love this. I just think it's beautiful. I must just like red carpet runways because I feel like every look I've liked.
Well, we all know you have low standards.
Oh. No, I like this. I think it's fun. I think it's beautiful. It's orange.
It is orange. That's a great observation. Amazing critique.
You.
It is orange.
I could have any number of STDs and you're criticizing me?
Yes, for having any number of STDs.
Use protection, I guess. That'd be my advice to the fans.
That'd be advice to yourself, I think.
Sure. No, I love it, and the makeup's cool. There's a fucking heart on her head that's also a koi fish. Mm-hmm. This is my favourite so far. This is glamour, this is sex, this is 20s flapper references. This is fucking stunning.
I agree with about 75% of what you said there. First of all, I also have to say that she has changed her makeup up. She is not freaky today. She is... she almost looks a bit like Sharon Needle's old makeup. They're kind of still a bit ooky spooky, but still feminine drag looking. She's not a monster today. Which I think we said last time was something she needed to do if she wanted to get on Michelle's side.
Yeah.
I love the concept. I love the headpiece. I think it's beautiful. I like the dress. I think with the boa over the top and all the different strands of it, it's a bit overwhelming. You do lose a bit of the silhouette.
The boa is 20s.
It is, but it's just together it's too overwhelming. It needs a little bit of editing, I think.
Okay.
She's just taken everything orange she has in her wardrobe and put it on. And
yeah, I guess.
It just needs a little bit of finesse. But overall, I do really like it. Just, there's something that doesn't quite hit the spot.
Bit of finesse.
Mm-hmm. But overall, I definitely give it 2.
I give this a 2. Oh my god. No, I give this a shoot.
It's orange.
Because it's orange. Shoot, bitch. Shoot. Shoot. Shoot.
Shoot, bitch.
The Russian shit is aggressive. Yeah, so up next we have Elle of a Day.
In a golden age of Hollywood inspired outfit. A sort of light peach.
Yeah. What do we think?
I am not vibing with this.
Really?
Yeah, it just all looks a bit washed out to me. Sort of the makeup washes in sort of the same color of the fabric, and then you can't really see the details on the gown because they don't stand out. They blend in with the fabric. Like if it was a black detailing or even gold, they might have done something more, but they're just too... It's too blurry.
No, I disagree, I like it.
There's something about the colour of the hair that doesn't go with the outfit either.
Really? I think this is very pretty.
It is pretty, but I don't know. It also makes her look bigger than she is.
Maybe.
Because the other day, as a guy, he's really in shape.
Oh yeah, I see.
But he looks kind of curvy. Yeah, it looks a bit odd.
No, I like it. I mean, I think it's probably the breastplate and the hips that make him look curvy, I guess.
Yeah.
But I think this is really beautiful. It's pretty. I love the satin and the pink, the shade of pink. I agree, I think maybe the detailing could have been a bit something darker, or maybe the colour of the dress could have been a little darker. But I think she was going for this sort of, it's sort of Asian in a way, that sort of lilac pink with sort of like a very light blue. It's very delicate and beautiful. Very 50s inspired.
Yeah, so I just don't like it overall. It doesn't speak to me. Yeah, so I give this one a boot.
Oh, I give this a tootah.
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 So up next we have Scarlet Harlot in Scarlet.
Yeah, this.
And I really love this. I think
really?
She looks stunning. Yeah.
So do I. I think she looks beautiful.
She looks incredibly feminine. She looks almost like Nicole Kidman in Moulin Rouge.
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah. She looks stunning.
Come on, Nicole. Love it. It's just gorgeous. It's very simple. You know, it's a simple idea, but it's just beautifully executed.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the way she's added that wide necklace, the ginger wig, she looks incredible.
She does.
Yeah.
I would say that the way she was walking down the runway, it looked like she was really thinking about holding up the bottom of the dress. And she sort of was hunched over with her shoulders. She didn't look like the most confident person. I think she was thinking too much about the dress.
Okay.
She was a bit like this.
Right.
Which kind of detracted from the elegance of it.
Okay, fair enough.
And as you said, it is a bit simple. It could have done with maybe some silver detailing. Just something to break up the monotone. It's a bit like Crystal Versace's. It's just the same colour all the way down. And it looks stunning, but maybe just needs something to break it up a bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
But overall, I still really love it.
It's nice, it's red, and you know what else is red? My
vagina.
Toot-a-boot.
This is a definite toot. I think she looks stunning.
Toot! Up next, we have Victoria Scone.
And she's also wearing red, which I think was odd, because if you look at all of the other ones, they show it in a second, that all of them lined up together, they're each wearing a really distinct colour.
Yeah.
So how does it happen that Victoria Scone and Scarlett are wearing the same colour?
I don't know.
But yes, so the outfit does not speak to me, really. I don't like it much at all. It's the same with Ella Bidet. The detailing on the dress is just lost because it doesn't stand out against it's like red on red. The hair in combination with that really chunky necklace, there's just too much around her neck. I don't think the makeup really goes with the look. It went with her previous campy looks, but she's trying to be elegant and glamorous in this one, and she's got kimchi makeup on.
Yeah.
And I don't like it. Her body doesn't look as nice as it was before, because she was really, like the curves were really distinguished before.
Distinguished.
And this is a bit of a blob.
Yeah. This is not good. Yeah, I agree. I did drag myself actually. One of my earlier looks was red with a very bleached blonde, with a light blonde wig like that.
You did drag?
I'm actually a biological woman.
Oh yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah, sorry. And no, obviously I'm a biological woman. This biological woman, who is a stunning drag queen, is not stunning enough tonight. I just think, you know what it is? I think as a drag queen, she's used to being campy and over the top. And this is probably a stretch for her. She's not used to doing this.
Mm-hmm.
And she has not hit it out of the park. I hate the neckline.
Mm-hmm.
I hate... I don't agree that it's like Ella Bidet's. I think that this is red on red. Whereas at least Ella's was blue on pink. This is literally red on red, so you can't see the detail. I hate the wig. A bleach blonde with red, not grey.
It's like a white wig.
That's what I mean, white with red.
This is Mrs. Claus.
Yeah, it's very baby drag for me. Somewhere between baby drag and producer number 3 at the Oscars or something. Someone who worked on the crew of a big film. It's a neckline, that's where she really goes wrong.
It does look very weird.
Yeah, if it didn't have that neckline, it might look fine. Might look good.
No?
No.
Yeah, this is definitely a boot for me. Yeah, the more I'm looking at it, the more I just don't like it.
This is a boot.
So, that was all of the red carpet eleganza looks of the week. Who was your top toot of the week?
I liked Charity Case would have been my top look of the week. She's my top! She looked fucking stunning!
For me, it would be... I think it would be Crystal again. Yeah, I just really liked that outfit. The way she sold it, the way she moved in the dress. I love the colour emerald green as well. So maybe I'm just biased in that way. But she looked, to quote Aja, she looked like Linda Evangelista. Really, she looked...
Oh.
She did look amazing.
Yeah. You're perfect, you're beautiful, you look like Linda Evangelista, you're a model. Mm-hmm. Oh, your smile is beautiful.
I can tell you rehearsed that to yourself in the mirror.
You're perfect, you're beautiful. Yeah. Oh, you're smiling. Who's your bottom? Who?
It would have to be Victoria. Sorry, Victoria. It just didn't live up to any of the others, even the ones I didn't like of the others, like the other day. Victoria was just the worst.
I second that, Victoria. You looked, she looked not drag enough, apart from the makeup and the wig, which was too drag.
didn't go together. It wasn't cohesive.
It wasn't cohesive, it wasn't great. Victoria is my bottom boot of the week.
Well, that is it for this week's episode. We've gone down to 10 queens, I believe. So we will have 10 looks to review next week.
And then there were 10.
A 10 in your bed.
So if you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. You can hit the bell icon just below to be notified when the next video comes out. And we will see you next week.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you don't like and subscribe, she's going to send her Russian hackers to infect your computer with viruses.
I will send the Russian hackers to kill you and your family.
All right.
It's not a joke. It's a joke!
Even I feel scared now.
You should be. Okay.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Goodbye.
What's goodbye, Russian?
Rovsky.
Rovsky. Yeah.
Rovsky. It's Mallamumrow.